There are little girls all over this town, all over this county, all over this state that need our love and help and devotion. And this song, you may just never know what some of them become. And this is for Suzanne. Somewhere in the world today, a little girl will go out to play, all dressed up in mama's clothes. At least the way that I suppose it goes. Somewhere in the world tonight, before she reaches to turn out the light, she'll be praying from a tender heart. A simple prayer, that's a work of art. And I don't even know her name, but I'm praying for her just the same, that the Lord would write His name upon her heart. 'Cause somewhere in the course of this life, a little boy will need a godly wife. So hold on to Jesus, baby, wherever you are. Somewhere in the world out there, this little girl is learning how to care. She's picking up her mama's charms, or maybe swinging round in her daddy's arms. Somewhere in the world to be, though the future's not real clear to me, theirs could be a tender love, grounded in eternal love above. And I don't even know her name, but I'm praying for her just the same, that the Lord would write His name upon her heart. 'Cause somewhere in the course of this life, my little boy will need a godly wife. Hold on to Jesus, baby, wherever you are. Hold on to Jesus, baby, wherever you
So at this time, we're going to turn it over to the Well, Suzanne, and these wonderful ladies. So I think we have a video first. Is that correct? Watching.
Hi, I'm Dana. I'm the executive director of Healing Springs. I just wanted to share with you today a testimony from one of our residents, Alexis.
What made me decide to move into Healing Springs was I saw it as a great opportunity, especially just being able to live on my own and really growing in myself. The opportunities that I have because of Healing Springs is I'm able to go to school. I have a lot of accountability and a great community of people supporting me. Everything is so close-knit, right where I need it to be for things to be like set in motion in my life. So, you know, school's right down the road, my gym's right down the road, church is right down the road, and I'm close to my family. In group on Thursday nights, I've really been able to start to see the things that I need to heal from. And it's just amazing having other people around me, being able to share that and grow with them.
Thank you, everybody. Tom, Chuck, and I were just talking about, I've been coming to this church for 38 years. I was two, of course. So most of you know me here. My name is Suzanne Tobey, and I'm a clinical therapist. I have my own practice in Ortonville, but I'm also the clinical director of The Well. The Well is located at the corner of Voorhees and Elizabeth Lake Road, and we also have a new program that we started about a year ago. It's independent living program for these young girls. Dana is the founder of The Well. She had a dream to reach out to young ladies to tell them about Jesus. And as that dream came to be, there was an abandoned building or abandoned home on Voorhees Road that Dana and a lot of wonderful volunteers came together and just made that old abandoned home a thing of beauty. The Well is a gathering place for young women and young girls. We do not have anybody that lives at The Well. We just work in the program to develop these young lives. And so as the day goes on, we have programs that we serve them, things to learn from. Our program exists for a day of rest and to hear the good news about the Lord. Some of the organizations that we host at The Well are Life Challenge, Crossroads for Youth, Grace Centers of Hope, Children's Village, and a teen program called Bloom. So most come weekly for an afternoon to hear inspirational speakers and to have a home-cooked meal. We also have art projects and crafts that they can take home with them. And we have young women there that will speak to them, that are just there available to talk to them, to listen to them, and to pray with them. One of the things that I've learned from being at The Well is that there are women that have never had a home. They've never had someone to cook a home-cooked meal. They've never had someone tuck them in at night or read them stories and tell them about Jesus. I think that was the most amazing thing for me to learn about with working with all these women across our county. Healing Springs has been developed, and it's a comprehensive program. It's a Christ-centered program, and we have girls there from we have four girls, but their ages range from 18 to 30. And they're just in need of learning and transitioning into adulthood. The Healing Springs is actually just 2 miles away from The Well. Some of these young ladies have come from abused or neglected homes or been abandoned. And they often have struggled just to learn to trust. Some of them have developed unhealthy coping skills as a means of survival. They may appear to be indifferent or self-centered in their relationships. I'm not speaking directly about our girls at Healing Springs, but just in general, when we talk about women that have gone through the struggles of abandonment and abuse. So they're learning new ways to understand their world. We want to support them in their healing. At Healing Springs, we lead by example. Our ladies are learning from their own struggles and leaning into Jesus as He shows them how really precious and beautiful that they are. God's will and plan for their life is developing while they live at Healing Springs. Many of the things that they're learning is self-awareness, commitment and follow-through, career development, and life goals. They're taking care of themselves physically, spiritually, and mentally. These ladies are required to have a job, they go to college, or they're learning a life skill. They attend church, they buy their own groceries, and they learn how to cook. They attend group with us, and in the last two groups that we've had, we were working in a series called codependent no more. Thanks, Leticia. And also, we've done Keys to Freedom, which has been a really inspiring group for all of us. They're also learning about how to handle depression and anxiety. They must attend weekly therapy. They have household chores to do. And they also donate their time to the well. They come and to our programs, and they're there to mingle or to help Dana and I. Dana and I come there to be a blessing and a support to these girls. But mostly, they bless us. Seriously. Galatians 6:2 says, "Carry each other's burdens, and in this we will fulfill the love of Christ." No one should walk through this world alone. We need to walk with others in their time of need, and in many ways we can lighten the load and give hope for a future just by giving them the tools to carry out God's message for their lives. So we're here today in hopes that others may want to sponsor one of our girls or make donations for, you know, they need food. These are young, hungry girls. So if there's anything that touches your heart that you might see that or want to feel inspired to help our young ladies, we would really appreciate that. We've also begun a fundraiser initiative, and it's called Second Saturday. And it's an estate sale at the well. And so we have many items there, beautiful donated items, antiques, beautiful glassware, art that the girls have created. Many just cool things to help us support Healing Springs. So that's every second Saturday of each month. These girls were handpicked by us. They were prayed over. And they have a heart and desire to walk with the Lord. And that's why we have been able to bring this little house together. And we are just so inspired by them. So at this time, I want to introduce you to one of our amazing young ladies. And her name is Shania. So Shania, will you come up and tell a little bit about your story? Thank you.
Hello. So about a year and a half ago, almost 2 years, I was really lost, and I drank very heavy, and I used substances. I lived in anger, and I woke up basically mad every morning and at everything and everyone that was in my life. I stole, and I was addicted to pornography. The things that came out of my mouth were vulgar, rude, and just unpleasant. And all I wanted to do was party, go to clubs. It didn't really matter with who or where we would go. I didn't really care what could happen to me. This was all to escape and to numb myself from the hurt that I experienced as a child and just the trauma that I went through in life in general. And I had very toxic friendships and relationships and was very confused, and it led to a lot of anger. I lived in fear and shame and in guilt. I was not a good friend, not a good daughter or sister, and I basically blamed everyone else and everyone around me. And about a year and a half ago, I just kind of got to the end of myself, and I was tired of being angry and mad all the time. I was tired of drowning my pain and hurt with alcohol. And I was tired of blaming everyone. And I kind of got to the point just asking myself of this pattern of what I was doing. I'm like, is this it? And if it was, I didn't want to go on a second longer. And if I had to keep living that way and carrying all this. And so one night I just cried out and I called out for help to God, and I just prayed, like, God, if you're real, help me to do better, and I want to feel better and do better. And there he was in an instant, and he revealed himself to me, and it was like he was waiting on me to ask for his help. He just slowly, like, but amazingly started changing me and transforming my life, and started to reveal the truth about things, about a lot of things. And the anger that I was dealing with and just all the hurt was not only hurting those around me, but it was hurting me most of all. And I didn't want to walk around like that anymore. And I found his joy, and he showed me forgiveness, and I started to experience a joy like no other. And it didn't matter, like, the chaos that was, or confusion that was around me or within me, I just had his joy. And I don't know where it had came from, but I wanted to stop drinking, and it had no effect on me. And so I've been sober from alcohol since August of 2020. Thank you. And I have been clean of any substances since November of 2020. Thank you. And he fixed my very vulgar and unpleasant mouth in an instant. And he just prepared me, because in last year, it was one of the hardest years of my life. There was so much loss and grief and trauma last year, but he prepared me, and it felt like he was holding me, like carrying me, and just shielding my heart from things that were going on and from the loss of family members. And during this time of finding God, I kind of did away with all the people I used to hang out with and just who I surrounded myself with. And it was just me. And like, I was like by myself all the time. And he surrounded me now with just amazing people. And he's renewing my mind. And he's now giving me back and returning the things that was stolen from me. And even as we speak now, he has brought me into a season of healing mentally, emotionally, and physically. He's healed my body of a lot of things, from just what I was in and what I did. And he, you know, is in the process of healing my heart, and I know restoration is on the way. And I'm still learning, and I make mistakes. I'm not perfect, but all of these things that I've told you are, it was all God, and he gets all the glory, and it was not me at all. And it was all him, and it still is, and it will forever be him. He is a God of healing and restoration, forgiveness. And I just believe that as his children, we, like, he's just waiting for us to ask for his help, to call out to him. And one of the greatest blessings to this day that I have received from him is the Healing Springs program. And it has just been so amazing there. And it has been so much healing already in my life. And I'm learning how to live my life with God. And I'm blessed with so many amazing mentors and friends that I know that God handpicked for me. I'm just so grateful to all of them and the entire program. And I starting school in the fall, and I feel like I'm going to be able to do this time because I have him. So that is it. Yeah.
Beautiful. Sure. Hi, honey. Lakeisha. Good to see you, honey. Good to see you. What a beautiful testimony. Thank you so much, Shania. The Bible says that real religion is visiting widows and orphans in their, get the word, distress. That's exactly what Shania just explained to us, that she had suffered for all these years. We're going to be taking an offering for the well, but the well and Healing Springs should be part of all of our regular giving. Very important. I also want to say something else. Suzanne Toby has been an incredible mentor in this whole situation, but she's been an incredible therapist and help to God's people for decades. If you're lucky enough to get an appointment with her, because she's so slammed all the time. But what I want to say is that she also suffers with a couple physical illnesses that they're chronic and they go on and they're severe, and she keeps powering through all of this for all of these years. We're proud of you, Suzanne. And thank you. All right. Let's stand together to pray. We're going to ask God's blessing on the well and Healing Springs and their great work. Lord Jesus, we recognize what you're doing, that your hand is here on that, the well, Healing Springs. Suzanne, Dana, all of those working and living and healing in these situations. We ask for your blessing, Father, to be poured out, that you would lift the burden of those who direct this ministry, and that you would help them open the windows of heaven on them. Thank you. Father, for Suzanne, we ask for blessing beyond blessing. We ask you for health for her, for stamina, for all that she needs in this great work that she's doing. And Father, I thank you also for Shania today. And we thank you that in her journey, that you will never leave her, and that you're going to continue to bless her and help her. But she's also taken a public stand today, Lord. And we know the enemy doesn't like that. So we thank you for your protection and blessing over her life today. Thank you for all your people here today. And we ask for your blessing as we leave. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you for listening. If you would like to support Community Bible Church, we would appreciate your prayers and gifts. We can be reached at Community Bible Church, 1888 Crescent Lake Road, Waterford, Michigan, 48327, or at our website, www.cbcmi.com. We'd appreciate your gifts. We know that many can't give right now, so if you would, you'd be a great blessing to your brothers and sisters. God bless you. Have a great day.